Hi everyone! Microsoft Loop helps Teams users to keep organized their recurring meetings. There is now a new feature available for your recurring meeting that helps an organizer to create a dedicated workspace to the recurring meetings. Every content that you share along your recurring meetings, like files, recordings, loop components, and so on, will be automatically uploaded and linked to the Microsoft Loop workspace. So it would be extremely easy for the organizer to structure in one single place every meeting. All right, let me show you how this feature works. Let's go. Here I am in a Microsoft Teams. I ended this meeting. This is our current meeting, and it was the first meeting that I made. When you create a recurrent meeting, when the first meeting ends, you are going to have this option available, which it makes totally sense, having a loop workspace to handle your recurrent meeting. It is extremely easy to use a workspace to handle your daily stand-up meeting, for example, or your follow-up meetings. Now let's click on this button to open a new tab in the browser. Microsoft Loop will open, and here what I have is this experience. Automatically I have the name of this, the title of the meeting, and I have added to the workspace all participants to this meeting. This is done automatically. Let's click on continue, and what I have here is the ability to add elements that was part of the meeting, like for example meeting notes, the recording, and I have even the whiteboard. If you share file, you are going to find everything here, so I can select or unselect elements to add in the workspace. So now I selected all three elements, and what I can do here is going on the description, add some description if I want, or click on the button create. Now that I'm here, I can add pages, or I can structure the loop workspace on my needs. Now, important to know is that every element of the meeting, the recording, the whiteboard, and notes are here linked, and these things are dropped in the OneDrive of the organizer. So I created a first page here with a name, meeting, and then the date of the meeting. This will help me to check immediately in which meeting I want to have more information. Now, for example, it could make totally sense to drop these elements under this page, because this keep things and the structure better organized for my point of view. I can see that all the elements about this specific meetings are here as a subpage, and this makes easy to jump and check every element related to this specific meeting. In the chat, there is a new post here. I added the meeting content to a loop workspace. Check it out. So other attendees can join this workspace. There we go. I just ended the second meeting of these recurring meetings. And as in the first meeting, I have this button open in loop workspace just next to the meeting ended. So let's click on it. Now a new tab is, it will open, and here I can then create another page, and automatically I have on top of every page all elements of the second meeting. So this makes totally easy now to create another page with the name of the meeting. In this case could be exactly this one, but I'm going to change now the title. I'm going to adopt that was to the day after, and there we go. So now I created another page, and what basically I can do, so let me delete this one. So what basically I can do is create the same situation that we have done before, and having every element of the second meeting just as a subpage. And this is now, it's more easy to follow the contents on your recurring meeting. I hope that this video helps you to better keep organized your Teams meeting using Microsoft Loop. If you enjoyed this video, please consider to subscribe, like, and add a comment down below. Let me know what do you think about this feature and if something is still missing. I hope to see you next time. Bye.